In this video, I'm going to show you the new and latest features of Adobe Premiere Pro 2022. Hey, what's up? It's Xander, Douik, and if you're new to my channel, well, this YouTube channel is all about photography, filmmaking and visual effects. So definitely subscribe to my channel and enable notifications to get notified whenever I upload new content. And now let's get to work. Now the first update is called Remix. So if you have a song that does not fit the length of your video, what Remix can do is to make it longer or shorter with just one click. Which makes my previous video on how to extend music to match the length of your video completely useless. So select your song, come here to the Essential Sound panel and click Edit. Then select Music and enable Duration, and here you can see some new options. Check Remix, then dial the target duration value up or down depending on the length of the video. And that's it. Premiere Pro will automatically remix the song and change its duration, and you can also raise and shorten the duplicated segments or lower and make them longer segments. You can also tell Premiere Pro to focus on harmonics or timbre parts to make the cuts, which make this an amazing feature. The next feature is speech to text. Go to Window, select Text, which will open up a new panel, and click on Create Transcription. Choose where your clip is located inside the timeline and choose its language. You can also add different speakers if there are any, then just hit transcribe and it will begin to transcribe automatically. It is a great feature that saves a good amount of time. And if there are some mistakes, you can easily retype them. And you can see here on the left that it detects the speakers, which you could rename to be more organized. Finally, click on Create Captions and choose the captions format. If you are not sure about that, just choose the default subtitle format. Then you can stylize it if you want, or just add a pre-made style, then click on Create. And that's it! A new subtitle track will be added to your timeline and synced with your video. Now for the next feature, which is the new import and export workflow when you launch Premiere Pro. You can see here on the top left corner, Import, which is this media browser that we're in right now, in which you can create a new project, change its name, location, and so on. Now this is a more organized workflow where you can see all your media files. Once you choose your clip, you can come here to the right side of the panel and see some import settings. Like if you want to copy your media over to the project folder, which is useful for if you're browsing from your SD card. You can also create a new bin if you want to store all your footages in there. And finally, you can create a new sequence from that clip you selected, but it will also import all of your clips into that sequence. Now, if you don't want to use these options, you can just disable them, then click on Create to come into the familiar Premiere workflow. And when you're done editing, you can come here to the Export tab. But don't panic, it works the same as the old Export panel, just in a new different tab. If you can't find the preset you want, you can click on More Presets and access the full list from this menu. And if you click on this star next to the presets, you can add it to your favorites, so it will appear on the smaller menu. And that's everything about the new workflow feature. Next, this is a small but useful feature which allows you to restore edit points you selected on your timeline that you may have accidentally deselected. If we go to Edit, then Keyboard Shortcuts, search for the Restore Trim Selection, then assign a shortcut for it. And now if you make multiple trim selections by holding down Shift, but then you accidentally click away. Now, fortunately with this new feature, with just one click on your shortcut, you can restore your selections.
It may seem too trivial, but trust me, it will save you time. Now these are the best new features, but there are some small updates like the new colorized vector scope, improved histogram, limit recurve refinements, improved media relinking for team projects, improved bars and tone, new GPU acceleration for effects, and the list goes on. You can read all about it on the Adobe website, and I will leave a link to it in the description below. And that's it! Thank you guys for watching. If you have any ideas or suggestions for future videos, don't hesitate to engage with me in the comments below. And I hope you like this video. If you do, push the thumbs up button, and of course, don't forget to subscribe for more videos, and see you in the next one.
Hey, what's up, Xander here. And if you're new to my channel, well, this YouTube channel is all about photography, filmmaking, and visual effects. So definitely subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications to get notified whenever I upload new content. Now, let's get to work.